Good morning, everyone. Sorry for the goofiness there. That was on purpose, in case you thought it wasn't. That's just what I do every time I do these videos. I'm always like off the side reaching, so you can't see me in the video. But I purposely kind of put my head in the corner so you can kind of see what I look like each time I do this. So you can see the picture in my background. And today, that is a very distraught Baker Mayfield. He looks like a bad detective in a Adam Sandler movie or something. Like, he's got that trench coat, that bad mustache. But yeah, Baker is very distraught. He had a great game for me. He's not even supposed to be playing. I mean, Anthony Richardson just has been a huge flop. So Nathan, be glad you did not get him, because he is doing terribly, and Josh Allen is absolutely blowing it up for you. So don't be sad you missed out there. But yeah, Baker Mayfield and Brady Gaga, we've lost three in a row, and I think that's the first time ever in my fantasy football league career that Brady Gaga's lost three games in a row. So that's what the U2 just haven't found what we're looking for. I just haven't found that lineup yet. So try and always tie the song to kind of the day and how I'm feeling. Usually what my team's doing, but I know you guys don't want to care about that. But yeah, distraught Baker Mayfield, bummed out U2 song. Well, that's where we're at. I am going to share something with you at the end of this video, though, that the movie Sing 2, it's fantastic if you haven't seen it. Having kids has opened me up to some great kids movies, and they really make these for adults now too. But Sing 2, oh man, the last scene, it tears me up every time I've seen it. Numerous times, and I still tear up. But anyways, I digress here. Let's get to that scoreboard, and maybe we could see what Brady Gaga is doing wrong. A lot of you guys are not doing anything wrong. We got a lot of people really tearing it up out there, and we'll give you guys some praise as well. But the scoreboard from this week: Matt moved to 4-0, just crushing Brady Gaga. 162 to 136, despite Baker Mayfield and Jaden Reed just having huge gains for me. This had nothing else from anybody at my bench. I had some guys on my bench, but so did Matt. So just stinks. 1-3, Brady Gaga. Amy KP took down Nick 122 to 115, despite 43 points from Jared Goff for Nick. Becky Hazy, she pulled off a close one to go to 4-0 as well. She took down Tony, who's now 0-4, 148 to 144. That's probably the game of the week. Should have saved that one for last, but a very close matchup there. Becky moved to 4-0 on the year. Mike moved to 2-2, and he dropped Nelly to 2-2 with a 189-146 wins. The 49ers defense just tearing up 60 points. Justin Fields, who would have thought? Justin Fields, 44 points. For Nelly there. Leanne picked up her first win, 177 to 115 over Karen. Derrick Henry, 50 points for her. Outstanding job there. Fail Mary. Lisa also picked up her first win, 142 to 99 over Keegan. Jordan Love back in the lineup, another quarterback I wanted to draft. But Lisa beat me to him, 51 points for Jordan Love after missing a couple weeks there. Skibbity football, Nathan, without Anthony Richardson, the guy he wanted, moved to 4-0. He takes down Jeanette 146 to 132. Ankeny Natron, he beats up on Team McDonald 118 to 50. Team McDonald says he's not participating very much this year. That'll be fine. He can go out and win that Ruby Ducey if he wants to. But Nathan with the win there. Team Webb takes down Madison 151 to 132. Three, Chuba Hubbard. That's a fun name. I thought it was Chuba, but I think it is Chuba. Yeah, Brock Purdy's brother, too. That's Chuba Purdy. I think this is Chuba Hubbard, maybe, or is it the other way around? I don't know. Yeah, Chuba Hubbard tearing up for him there. And his kicker from the Falcons, 26 points. And how about this? We'll give game of the week to Team Christine. Team Christine is now 4-0. She takes down Eric 113 to 102. The Vikings defense turn up. Team Christine, another 4-0 people. Speaking of 4-0 people, let's give them some love here as we take a look at the standings. In the Southview Division, we have Matt and we have Becky. They are both 4-0. They are both rolling right now. They have a two-game lead in our division already. 4-0, Matt and Becky. Great job out of you two. Nelly, Karen, Mike, Amy, and Nick are all 2-2. Then you have Brady Gaga and Leanne at 1-3. And Tony remains the only team without a win yet this year. He is 0-4 to start the year. And maybe I did curse you a little bit at the beginning of the year, Tony, by saying you're dead to me. Did I say you're dead to me? That was pretty mean if I did, so I apologize for that. But maybe stealing CJ Stroud from me gave you the big curse here, and you're 0-4. But yeah, you're dead to me. That's pretty harsh, Tony. Sorry if I offended you a little bit. I apologize, buddy. You're a great guy, Tony, and you didn't deserve that. But anyways, over to the Hawks division. Team Christine, Team X-Dean, and Skibbity Football, Nathan. 4-0 for both of them as well. So we have four undefeated teams remaining. Ankeny Natron, Nathan Combs is 3-1, a game back. Then you have Team Webb and SFMF at 2-2. Dak to the Future, great name, Madison. Fail Mary, which is also a great name. The Misfits, Team McDonald, and the new guy are all 1-3. We're only 4 weeks in. And if you're like me and you haven't found what you're looking for in your lineup yet, we're going to be okay. The highest scoring team in the league is Matt at a 631 points. Team Christine, Skibbity Football, I've also scored over 600. The team has had the most, the kind of the bad luck, the most points scored against them is Dak the Future. 597 points scored against her. Team McDonald, 593, and Leanne, 580. The luckiest teams, you want to call them, with the least points scored against them, Team Christine and her deficit, 620 to 452. She's been pounding people. Nick has also only given up 458 points as well, or given up. The teams against you have only scored that. So let's look at next week then here. As we go to week five, it's week five. I mean, we are at conferences. The fall season just always rolls by. But anyways, I'm taking a lot of time there. I better speed up. We have me versus Karen. Right now I'm favored 135 to 101. That's the first time I've been favored in a while. Does say Anthony Richardson is going to score more than Baker Mayfield, but I think I'm going to stick with the Bake and that bad mustache. And that was a few years ago. I don't think he has that mustache anymore. But yeah, I'm favored over Karen. Then we have Tony. He is favored this week, 132 to 110 over Amy KP. So maybe Tony will get that first win of the season. Hoping for you there, Tony. Matt is favored to go 5-0. He's favored over Nick, 114 to 75. Becky also favored to go 5-0. She's favored over Mike, 138 to 119. Leanne favored over Nelly, 140 to 135. And what looks to be might be the game of the week. Because that's the closest deficit, I guess. So, man, we'll say Leanne and Nelly is the game of the week for right now. Skibbity Football, Nathan, he's favored to go 5-0 as well, 146 to 125 over Keegan. In a battle of 1-3 teams, Fail Mary favored big, 145 to 102 over Tyler. Madison favored 136 to 100 over Jeanette. Ankeny Natron favored 108 to 95 over Eric. And Team Christine, she's favored to go 5-0 over Ryan, 133 to 100. So that's the games for this week. Again, I promised you this scene. You don't have to watch this scene, but this thing tears me up every time. I don't know why, but we're going to share my screen here if I can. Share the screen. We also want to, I don't know if we're going to be able to share our audio or not, but that's always, how do I get rid of this thing? Holy cow. Oh man, struggle city here in the production office. But yeah, this scene, I don't think we're going to be able to share our music. It tears me up for sure every time when that riff starts.
I have run through the fields only to be with you. Only to be with you. But I still haven't found what I'm looking for. But I still haven't found what I'm looking for.
If you haven't seen this movie, this is the
But
old retired singer. He's supposed to be coming out next. He's really nervous. This is his deceased wife. That's not real. He's imagining her. And then his part starts up. That's where the tear up always comes from. I don't know if you can hear it or not. I hope you can. But yeah, and they actually have Bono as the voice of this guy. Great, great scene, great movie. If you haven't watched it,
it's a
I
world,
highly advise.
it's a world, but
Now I'm
yeah.
sharing it. The sound. If you haven't seen it, I highly advise you see it. It's great. The music is fantastic. My kids love it. And I seriously, I tear up at that point. I don't know. It's just like the crowd singing. That guy, he kind of, they've had to fight him all show to get him out there. So I digress again. I'm just taking too long. We're going to get out of here. Even though we're 1-3 and we lost 3 games in a row for the first time ever, we are still all over Brady Gaga. Go Brady Gaga. I still believe in you guys. We're going to do it. We're going to figure it out eventually and get a win. Congrats to all you 4-0 teams. Tony, hope we get your first win, buddy. We'll take you out with some more Sing 2. Still haven't found what we're looking for, Brady Gaga, but we will find it eventually. Karen, appreciate everything you do in the office, but you are going down. I am going to beat you this week and break that 3-game lead. I am going to enjoy my Rolos. Not on the bracket this month, but they are very tasty. I'm also going to drink my water. I got to beat Ryan in the water contest. That guy just chugs water. I don't know how he does it. Been a long show. Sorry, Matt. Sorry, everybody. Had a lot to share. Best of luck. Little Birdie Gaga. What Sing 2. I'm out.